Hi everyone and welcome back. It's Vicky here and today I'm sharing three cards, all of them with a twist. They are really fun to create and I will be featuring products from Art Impressions. I have a bunch of stamps here and I will be using three of those for today's card. So this one is called Doghouse Cubies and it's one of their Cubies collection. Really fun and I will be using that today. Now this is hilarious, it's called Loads of Fun Set and it comes with this lady on the ironing board. It has a lot and lots of sentiments. And here is another one, again very unique. It's one of the sets from their Willys collection and she can actually ride the bike. And they give you inside not only the stamps but also the instructions, the brads and the dies that you need to make this work. This is one from their flip cards collection. It's called Octopus Flip Card and I will be using this today and you will see how fun it is and how easy it is to get this look. To make it easier for you, there is a die for those flip cards and this die works with any of the stamp sets in this collection. And I will be using this today so you will see how it works. My all-time favorite collection by Art Impressions is their Trifolds and this is the Front Porch Trifold. It gives you three stamps and a couple of dies that you can put one on top of the other to create a little scene. I will be using that today. And finally I have this Art Impressions stamp which I think it is adorable, perfect for birthdays, with three images of this hedgehog in different positions. Really fun! So I'm going to start with the flip card and I'm just separating the die here. To start with that, you need to have a paper that is 6.5 by 5.5. And don't worry, there is a leaflet inside that explains exactly what you need to cut and how you're going to use it. Now I need to place the die at 3.25. Of course, you can use a ruler and a pencil to add a mark on where that 3.25 is. Instead, I'm using my scoring board just because I find it easier. So then I place the die on top, run it through my Big Shot, and here is what you get. So here is what you get when you use that die. And I'm going to use my bone folder to reinforce that scoring line. So all the measurements and the die cut were made so that this card fits inside a standard envelope. And you can see that it fits nicely inside, including the flap. Now all the available stamp sets for this collection that go and match perfectly with a die have two images, a front and a back. I am using my Misty to do all the stamping because I'm working on watercolor paper and on the rough side of the paper. So I am going to stamp the image with the octopus that is facing at the front and at the top I'm stamping at the same time the sentiment that says it's your birthday. I'm using Archival Ink, which is not going to move or smudge since I'm planning to work with my Arteza pens later on and that's why I'm stamping on watercolor paper and you can see that I didn't get a good impression obviously because I'm working on the textured side but that's why the Misty is for. I'm going to keep on stamping until I'm happy with the outcome. So here is what I have at the front. And now on the inside, I'm going to stamp the other octopus as well as the other sentiment. This time I'm going to get a better impression at the first stamping, since this is the smooth side of the watercolor paper. Still, I need to stamp a couple of times. So here is how it works, the front and the inside. Now I'm going to do all the coloring and today I decided to work with my Arteza pens. These are really fun and really easy to work with. You can follow the colors on the packaging since they give you a nice idea on how you can color it. I'm going to do a different color combo today. If you visit my blog, you will find an exclusive code that the guys over at Arteza gave for my audience. You can use it to get these markers in a great price with a great discount. The coupon code is valid until the 15th of April. Make sure to visit my blog to check it out. Now, in my videos, I usually focus on how to design the cards rather than on how you can color them. But you can see here the technique that I'm going with. I just add color at the darker areas of my image and then blend out the color with a water brush. And you can see that by using just one pen, I can get all those different variations of color. And of course, there are many other ways that you can use those pens, like blending two colors together. They blend beautifully, but always remember to work on watercolor paper. And of course, stamp your image with an ink that doesn't move. Now here I'm using the exact same technique to color the octopus on the inside of my card, and I will be using the exact same colors for the same objects on the front and on the inside. So here you can see how I colored the front. Now I'm going to move on the inside, and I have the markers that I used on the front next to me so that I don't make any mistakes, and I will go ahead and do that as well. And here is the finished card, and of course remember that you can use any coloring medium that you like. Now this is a finished card, but I like to take it a step further. For that I'm going to use a wave stencil that I have. I am going to secure it with some purple tape, and then I will go ahead and add some inking over it. This is going to give the illusion that the octopus is actually underwater. I am using Distress Oxide ink, and I apply it with a brush. This ensures that I don't apply too much ink over it, and I can go even over the octopus, since this tumbled glass that I am using is very pale. And you can see here the finished result. Now I'm going to repeat the same process on the inside of my card. And again I'm going to use my piece of purple tape to cover up the flap. And on the inside of this card, you have enough space to write your personal message at the top, where all that blank space is. And I finished off my card by adding three little bubbles coming out of my octopus. I like the unique design. It has something different than we usually create. And I think it's a really fun card for summer birthdays. Here are some close-up photos on the card. Now for my next card I'm going to use the Trifold Front Porch. This is just adorable. It comes with two dies and three stamps. There are instructions in the set, so don't worry about how you can put this together. But it's really easy. Those two dies match one of the stamps, so they actually create little windows that you can see through them on the other image. There are many ways to create gatefold cards like this one. If you want, you can follow their instructions and you will end up with this one that fits inside an envelope. And for this one, you start with a 4.5 by 11 cardstock. Now I have a piece of pattern paper that I want to cover the front with, since I don't want to be plain white, but this is a step that you can completely omit. Now I'm going to use a circle die that I had in my stash just to open up a window. And I made sure that the circle that I'm using here is bigger than the stamps, so that I will fit nicely to stamp inside. Now my card is ready. I need to do the stamping and the die cutting now, so I'm going to move on and stamp the first image on the front. And I am using my Misty here just to make sure that I end up having a good impression. So here's the first one, where you can see the stairs going to the porch and some flowers on the left and on the right. Now I need to use the die, make sure that I align it correctly, secure it with some purple tape, and then I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine. Make sure that as you run it through the die cutting machine, you open up the card completely, otherwise you are going to cut out through layers that you don't want to. So here is my little window at the front. Now I'm going to move on and work on the flap, on the other flap. To make sure that I align everything correctly, I'm just going to use a pencil and just add a little mark there, so I know exactly where I need to stamp the other image. Before I do the stamping, I need to erase my pencil lines. And don't worry if you don't align those images perfectly, they are really forgiving. You will still be able to see through those windows. Now again, I need to align the die over that empty space. I will secure it with my purple tape, use some washi tape. You need to make sure that this die is not going to move. Open up the card completely and run it through your die cutting machine. And you can see here how the window looks now, with the chair and the little cat on the porch. And I'm going to repeat the same process one more time. So I used my pencil to mark exactly where I need to align the third stamp. I'm going to do the stamping again with my Misty. And now the base of my card is ready. Now I need to add some color. And here is how my card is looking. I need to add some color now. I used 80 pounds cardstock for my card base, and I don't want to use alcohol markers because they are going to bleed at the back and you will be able to see that. That's why I decided to go with my Prismacolor pencils to do all the coloring. I mainly followed the colors that are on the packaging. I'm mainly focusing on how to create those card designs, so I'm going to move the video a little bit forward where I have all those images colored. And I did a really quick coloring with my pencils, not paying attention to details. At the end, I used Gamsol with those stamp tools, and they blend nicely together everything, so I don't end up having those pencil lines. And here is everything ready to go with all those layers, completing my front porch. I have also used dies to cut out this little white ring, which I'm going to place at the front. I think that completes the card nicely. On the inside, there is a sentiment that says no matter where you go, you can always come home. And that's why I decided to add the word home at the front. I used an alphabet die to cut out the letters out of white cardstock, and I'm gluing everything down using my Nouveau Deluxe glue. And here is the finished card with a window at the front and all the layers on the inside flaps. And you can see some close-up photos here. And keep in mind that Art Impressions has many more stamp sets that you can work with to create this type of trifold style cards with really adorable scenes that come together beautifully. Make sure that you check them out before you decide which one you want. For my last card, I'm going to use the Doghouse Cubies. This is a set and comes with the stamp set as well as the dies. And the dies actually cut out all the doors and the windows on those dog houses, so you can tuck inside the dogs that come with the stamp set. Now, this is really fun to create. I'm going to stamp first the houses, and I'm working on watercolor paper again, so that I can go ahead and color everything with my Real Brass Arteza pens. Now, for coloring the houses, I went with the rainbow color theme. So I'm starting with the red, and I will continue with orange, yellow. I will have the yellow popping at the top, that tiny little house at the top. Then I will move on to green and to blue. But there are not enough houses for all the rainbow colors. But you will see later on that I'm going to add a flag, which I'm going to color purple for that purple touch. Now I'm going to place the die on top, and this is going to cut out the doors and the windows. I'm going to secure it with some purple tape and run it through my Big Shot. And you will see that some of the doors and the windows pop out completely, but some of them create that little opening, which is just adorable. So you can see those two front doors open up now. So I stamped and colored my dogs and cut them out with the matching dies. I used 5 of them, but there are 7 different dogs in the stamp set. My dogs are going to come out of those houses, but I don't like the empty space that I have at the back. That's why I'm going to cut out a piece of this craft cardstock. I'm going to roughly draw around the die with a pencil. And then I'm going to use my scissors and cut out inside that pencil line. This is going to ensure that the piece that I have roughly matches the size of my houses. I can stick both of them with foam tape, one on top of the other. And then with my scissors, I'm going to make sure that all the edges are nicely and neat. It's really all about the details when I'm making cards, so I just couldn't stand having those windows and the doors looking at an empty space. Now I feel like my houses have an interior, and I can nicely tuck inside all those dogs. And can you see how dimensional it looks? Absolutely perfect. Now I'm going to create a background for my card, and I will be using 2 Distress Oxide colors for my sky and for my grass. I am applying everything with a foam blending tool to have nice saturation of color, and as I apply both the colors at the top and at the bottom of my card base, I will make sure that these two colors are not going to meet at any point. And I have a nice background for my dog houses to stay on. I used Nouveau Deluxe glue at the back to stick my houses down, make sure that they are nice and secure there. And I'm going to start sticking down all the pieces, so you can see there the flag for the touch of purple that was missing from my rainbow card. And I'm going to tuck in this guy at the back, coming out from the back. I think this is super adorable. And I will continue with the rest of the dogs. Some of them are going outside of the houses, looking through the windows or through the doors. I used the die that I had on my stash to cut out this speech bubble, and I stamped one of the sentiments from the same stamp set that says Happy Birthday from all of us, which I'm going to stick that on top of my card with foam squares, and my panel is ready. All I need to do is to just stick it on top of a card base. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. Don't forget that, just like always, you will find a full list of all the supplies that I used for this video down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. Also, there is a coupon code for the Arteza website if you want to check that out. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you had fun and that you got inspired, and I'll see you all next time.